Μια πολύ ωραία συνέντευξη που μας έδωσαν πριν από μερικές ημέρες, όχι χθες, δεν τους προλαβαίναμε χθες, γιατί προετοιμάζονται για τον ντέρμπι. Είναι καμιά εβδομάδα τώρα, όπου τους στρίμωξε εκεί ο Νίκος Παγκάκης, τον Μάρκους Μπεργκ και τον Μλάντεν Πέτριτς. Το πολύ καλό επιθετικό δίδυμο που έχουν οι πράσινοι. Λογικά αύριο θα ξεκινήσει μόνο ο Μπεργκ και ο Πέτριτς, αν μπει, θα μπει από τον πάγκο στην αναμέτρηση. Σε κάθε περίπτωση και οι δύο έδωσαν μια πολύ διαφορετική και ενδιαφέρουσα συνέντευξη στον Νίκο Παγκάκη. Για να το δούμε.
Έλα, Βόγλη, στο Ολυμπιακό Στάδιο είμαι. Περιμένω τους ποδοσφαιριστές. Δεν θα αργήσουν, είναι επαγγελματίες. Ναι, μην ανησυχείς, θα παίξεις κανονικά το βίντεο στον γκολ χωρίς σύνορα. Όλα καλά. Hello, guys, how are you?
Welcome.
Καλά όλα. Let's go.
Let's go, let's go.
Στην Ελλάδα έχει πάρα πολύ κίνηση, δεν ξέρω πώς ήρθατε ως εδώ, αλλά γενικά τα πράγματα είναι δύσκολα. Εσείς πώς την αντιμετωπίζετε, Μάρκους?
Yeah, the traffic is not what I'm used to, but yeah, I think it's... I haven't had any accident yet, so I'm happy. But yeah, you have to be ready, because I think sometimes it can come cars, yeah, everywhere, you know, from nowhere also, so you have to be careful.
Για να αλλάξουμε κεφάλαιο, κίνηση στον δρόμο, το θέμα είναι πως εσείς πρέπει να έχετε έντονη κίνηση και στο γήπεδο. Έχετε ντέρμπι την Κυριακή.
No, everyone wants to see this game. It's the biggest game in Greece. So yeah, we will do everything to win it. It's a difficult game, but yeah, it's this games, the kind of games you want to play. Big games against a good team. So looking forward to it.
It's your first time, eh? Πρώτη φορά.
Yes, for me it's the first time, and I'm looking forward to it as well. Of course, it's the biggest game of the season, and you can feel already weeks before how important it is for everyone. Sometimes it was difficult to stay focused on the other games because everyone is talking always about this game. And yeah, as he said, we will do everything, and I hope we will get a good result there.
Όλοι οι Έλληνες περιμένουν και συζητάνε το μεγάλο ποδοσφαιρικό ραντεβού στο Γιώργος Καραϊσκάκης. Οι αρμόδιοι να μας πούν πόσο έτοιμος είναι ο Παναθηναϊκός είναι σίγουρα ο Μλάντεν Πέτριτς και ο Μάρκους Μπεργκ. Μλάντεν, η ομάδα σε τι κατάσταση βρίσκεται για το μεγάλο παιχνίδι?
I think we are very ready. We had a good week and we trained hard and everyone is focused on the game and I'm sure we will have good game tomorrow. The psychology is, yeah, I hope it will stay good. I mean, we have a lot of young players, and it will be for sure. It will be a hot atmosphere in the stadium, and I hope that everyone can handle this and stay focused and give his best.
In the end, we know it's 3 points, you know, but we also know that it's worth more than 3 points if we can take them there. So we're looking forward to it, and we will do our best. I mean, it's a very tough game to play away, but yeah, we're looking forward to it. We have a good feeling in the team, so we will work hard, and hopefully we can get the 3 points, so a good result. No, but it's yeah. That's also how it works in football. You can play good and you can lose games, you know. But the most important is to win, and it doesn't matter if you play good. Of course, we want to play good, but the most important is to win to get the 3 points. So I think if we can do a game like we played home in Leoforos, we will have a good chance to win. It's depends on if we score our chances and yeah, if we do the work that we have to do to win this game.
Yeah, I like games like this, because at the end these are the most important games for everyone, and this is for what you train every day. I mean, it's much better you enjoy it more if you play in a full stadium, in a hot atmosphere, than in front of 200 people.
No, I think we are more ready, of course. I mean, in the beginning of the season, almost no one had experience from the Super League, you know, and now we played a lot of games here. I think it's only Mladen who is new, so, but he have experience enough, you know, so for the rest, I think we have played enough games, you know, and you know, we know how it works, and we've seen Olympiacos, it's a very good team, especially home, so... Yeah, for us, we're just gonna do our thing, you know. And you know, in a derby, you have to play with heart also, not only with the feet. So, and I think we can do that. We showed that some games, and yeah, we will try to do it.
Of course, you're looking forward to this game, but it's not like I'm dreaming of that every night. And I know how important it is and everything, but. I think you have to be, in one way, you have to be focused but calm as well, because otherwise you will lose your head in the game.
I don't think you can put focus on one player. I mean, when Mitroglou was there, of course, he scored a lot of goals, but now he's not there, then they will have some other players, you know, so they have, the whole team is good, so we have to be just focused on our task, you know, everyone have the different task on the pitch, and we just have to know what we're gonna do, then it will be good, I think.
Ο ΠΑΟΚ απέχει από τον Παναθηναϊκό βαθμολογικά, έχει πάρει μια απόσταση ασφαλείας, αλλά λένε στην Ελλάδα ότι στο τέλος ξυρίζουν τον γαμπρό. Πιστεύεις λοιπόν ότι ο Παναθηναϊκός προλαβαίνει να σφραγίσει το εισιτήριο της Ευρώπης, να βγει στο Champions League?
Like I said, when we play on our top level, we play really good, but we have to play like this every game, so... When and if we come into the playoffs, we have to take every game like a cup final, you know, so and do our best, and then in the end we will see what we can get.
The most important thing for us is to get the place in the playoffs, and then we will see what happens if we play like we can play, like we played at home against PAOK. Then I'm sure we can get something, but yeah, that's the point. You have to play all the games like this and not one game like this and the other one bad. So we will see what the playoffs will bring.
When I came here, yeah, I think it was only Bayrami and Da Silva here, so... Then we had a really young team, but now we have some more experienced players also, and I think it's good for everyone, you know, the young enthusiasm and also more experienced players. So it's a good mix, and yeah, we help each other, you know, everyone give everything, and yeah, we do this together. It's not young or old, everyone have a responsibility and have to do their best every day.
That's a good plan. I mean, it's not only here. A couple of teams in Europe, they have the same plan. And if you decide to work with the young players, I think you need always some experienced players which can lead and help them. And I think, as I said before, you can see the quality of the players. And if they keep working hard like that, I'm sure that Panathinaikos will have a good future again. What the fuck y'all like? Of course it helps if you know each other from before. We had, I think, 1.5 years or something like that together in Hamburg, and I think we hope that we can help each other on the pitch now again, because it's always, of course, it's always difficult if you're alone up front, or if you have someone next to you who you know from before, you know how you like the balls, where you run and everything, and I hope it will help us.
I agree with Mladen, of course. It's true, like you say, if you know each other from before, it's always easier, you know. So, yeah, and with his quality, it's easy to play with. So, I think it's gonna be good also. We have to work hard and, yeah, help each other. I hope it's gonna be good. is to reach Europe, and when it is, it's a hope as soon as possible, you know, after this season, but you never know, and I hope we can do it, and we have players to do it, and yeah, we have all the possibility to do it, but yeah, we will see now the next games, and if we go to the playoff, you never know what happened, but I think we have the chance to go there.
The club has a big history, and they played a lot of times in the Champions League and everything, and the whole Europe knows Panathinaikos. And as we said both before, if we continue work hard and everything goes well, the club will have a good future again, and I'm sure that we can reach again some good results and some good stuff.
Είδαμε πολλές φορές την ομάδα με τον Πανιόνιο, για παράδειγμα, θυμάμαι ένα παιχνίδι, να παίζει εξαιρετικό ποδόσφαιρο στο πρώτο ημίχρονο, να κάθεται στο δεύτερο ημίχρονο. Γιατί συμβαίνει αυτό με τον Παναθηναϊκό?
Yeah, it's a good question. We try to work on it because it happens sometimes this season, and yeah, we don't have a good answer, but we work on it, and yeah, we have to make our lower level a little bit higher. You know, it's you can play bad sometimes, but then you have to play better than we did some games.
Sometimes, if you don't have a good game, if you don't play well, most important is to defend well. To if you cannot score, you at least you can fight that you don't concede, and then. We still can have a good result.